Yo, this is your boy Skateboard B, and today I'm going to be showing you how to get all the way to CT15 in around 5 minutes. Let's do this. Early game, all you have to worry about is just putting on gear that levels up your max wearable item level. So for anyone who hasn't reached late game, who's watching this video, max wearable item level would be located in this menu if you are on any other consoles. And max wearable item level is basically your max potential of your gear. You want to basically make your average item level, which is your current gear, max with your max wearable potential gear, which max wearable item level, who haven't reached endgame. That's the most important thing, but for now you really don't have to concentrate on that. Just keep on putting higher gear and match yourself with just your max wearable item level. So first and foremost, the most important thing once you reach endgame, that people like make these grueling videos, 9 minute videos of this grueling information that sometimes they can't even explain it right. So I have to watch it multiple times to just process it. Basically, the most important thing of these items is those three stats. See how I hover over my helmet and see where it says bonus firepower, close range damage, cooldown reductions. Look at my chest piece. Bonus firepower, close range damage, cooldown reduction. Those three stats are highly and seriously most important of the game. This is whatever stats you, the way that you like playing, is how you will utilize these stats so that you do very well in the gameplay style that you're playing. For me, I like using the shotgun, so that's the reason why I roll with the bonus firepower and the close range damage, because that will give me the max potential of how much damage I can do up close. And I go with the cooldown reductions because there's abilities that I roll with that have a fast cooldown already, and with the cooldown reduction basically just brings it back instantly. And the cheapest way to do this, a good example right now that I'm gonna show you, is I'm gonna get this little blue piece helmet right now. My current helmet is at 49, but the blue piece over here is at 49. Now I'm gonna upgrade this blue piece to 50 so I can show you guys this, so that you guys can keep your stats up to the maximum of how they need to be, so that when you enter these CT solos, they're a way much more easier to handle. So let me go to that helmet piece, and now I'm going to click level up. When I click level up, it only requires leather, way much more cheaper than if I were to try to turn these purples right now into level 50. But if I were to go to my level 49 helmet right now and try to turn that to level 50, look how much it costs. It costs 55,000 of the currencies that you get from completing these expeditions, and it costs me 559 titanium to just upgrade this purple, while that blue to make it level 50 was only leather. So, and it wasn't it doesn't cost as much. So now imagine with a legendary. Let's level that up really quick. Now it's at 72,000, and the titanium required to level that up is 1,118. It's so much money to continue to leveling up these items up to your current level. So that's why your end game is going to be grinding for these blue gears with those three main stats that I was talking about. Let's go back to that helmet piece that we were gonna try to level up, for example. And now it's only gonna take leather to make it 50. Now I made it 50. Now I'm gonna increase its rarity. So now I'm gonna go to improve the rarity of that helmet. And look, it's only 600 of titanium compared to the 1,000 titanium that would take the legendary. So now I improve this item. Boom. This is where the RNG comes in, and this is where, see, it says boost your damage against enemies afflicted or get power from the ashes. Killing shots on enemies inflicted with ash will increase your power. And then this one's called Emergency Stance Golem. This is very, very, very good because this is actually something that I have on my current helmet that I'm wearing right now that I would actually like. So fortunate for me for this video as well that now all I have to do is put on this mod. Once I put on this mod, now all I have to do is put Bloodlust like this helmet has, and boom, now I have a helmet that's more stronger than the current one that I have now. So now I'm gonna put Bloodlust on the first one. So now I'm hella ecstatic. Now I literally have a helmet that was exactly the same stats, but now it's at level 50, and it was way cheaper to do that instead of just upgrading my purple helmet. And that is it, fellas. That is it. That's literally it. So F these 10 minute videos and F these 9 minute videos. That's literally what you do to keep your gear on par and max stats to level up all the way to C15. Trust me, this is how you're gonna be able to afford maintaining your level, and it's way much more cheaper. So basically, to summarize everything all in short, you want those three main stats, and you wanna level up blue gear to keep it at your, to level it up at your max wearable item level. So that is literally end game. You grind the blue gear and level it up to your current max wearable item level. So now, for anyone who has stuck to this video till now, that's all you need to know. Every other information that I'm about to release is basically for the trickster class. So if you don't roll with the trickster, you can roll with a few of these mods that actually will go with some of the other classes. But if this is not your gameplay style, or you do not play the trickster, feel free to leave. But please, if you guys can, leave a like and a comment and let me know if this actually helped you by getting straight to the point than trying to suffer these long videos. Thank you so much. And now let's get started on the trickster build. Thank you.